Hello student, welcome to my YouTube channel Reaction Concept. So student, I hope you guys are doing well in your home as the lockdown period is still not finished and your classes also going very smoothly. So in our chemistry, physical chemistry, we have discussing about solutions chapter number 2, and in solution we are discussing about colligative properties. We have discussed two colligative properties, that is depression of freezing point and relative lowering of vapor pressure. Today we will discuss about another colligative property named as elevation of boiling point. So without any further delay, let us start with our class today. So before discussing elevation of boiling point, we should know what is boiling point of a substance. So let us see what is boiling point of a substance. Boiling point. It is the point, it is a temperature of a substance at which it is generally a temperature at which the vapor pressure of the substance is equal to the atmospheric pressure. You see what happened. If you take a liquid, suppose pure solvent. Suppose it has a vapor pressure of P1 at temperature T degree Celsius. Okay. And the atmospheric pressure is 1 atm. When this P1, this vapor pressure become equal to the 1 atm, then this molecule on the surface of this liquid will try to vaporize. Okay, it will go to the vapor state from liquid, and this temperature is called boiling point of the substance. Okay, this is all about boiling point of a substance. So now we'll discuss about elevation of boiling point. This is a colligative property. Generally in case of solutions it happens. So you see, suppose you have a pure liquid, pure solvent you have, okay, A, and this pure solvent have a vapor pressure of PA0. This is your vapor pressure, okay, and this vapor pressure is equal to 1 atm, equal to the atmospheric pressure, and this temperature is suppose T1 degree Celsius or T Kelvin. Okay, at what temperature its vapor pressure become equal to the atmospheric pressure at T1 Kelvin. When we add a non-volatile solvent, non-volatile solute to this pure solvent, we will get a what? Mixture of A and B. Okay, in this mixture of A and B, we will get a vapor pressure of this solution, suppose P, equal to 1 atm. This vapor pressure is attained at temperature, suppose T2 Kelvin. It is observed that this temperature at which this particle started to vaporize is generally greater than the T1. This phenomenon is called elevation of boiling point. You see, here elevation of boiling point is T1, boiling point is T1, here T2, and T2 is greater than T1. This increase is called elevation of boiling point. Now we see the reason behind this elevation. Why this happens in case of solution? You see, in case of pure solvent, there is a vapor on the pure solvent, okay, and this vapor will exert a vapor pressure on the solution liquid surface. When we add non-volatile solvent solute on this vapor, the vapor pressure of this liquid will decrease. This I already explained. Why? Because the surface of this liquid will occupy by the non-volatile solute. That is why vapor pressure would be decreased. So to vaporize this solution, this liquid part, we have to increase the temperature, because with increase in temperature, this vapor pressure will become to the 1 atm pressure. Okay, that increase in heat causes the increase in the boiling point of the solution. Okay, this suppose, and this is generally represented by del TB, where del, it is given by del TS and minus del T naught. This is the del T naught is the boiling point of solution. It is the boiling point of pure solvent. Okay, and this is generally given by I into KB into M. It is the Van't Hoff factor. It is called elevation constant, boiling elevation constant, and this is molality of the solution. Okay, this formula you should remember. What? Del TB equal to I into KB into molality. This KB also has a specific value. This is experimental value. We are not going to the derivation of this KB value. We just So what we have got from the above discussion, that elevation of boiling point of a solution is del TB given by TS by minus T naught. Okay, del TB equal to IKB into M, where I is the Van't Hoff factor, KB is the elevation constant, and is the molality of the solution. And this KB is a constant for a solvent. For a specific solvent, the KB value is specific. For water, it is 1.86 kilo Kelvin molar inverse one. Okay, and this KB has a expression, but you have to remember, this is given by RT square divided by 1000 into L into phi, or RT square 1000 into del H V divided by M. This is the expression for KB. This you should memorize these things. In your syllabus, derivation of this equation is not included. Okay, here it is. R is the what? R is the gas constant, ideal gas constant. T is the boiling point of the solvent. L V is the latent heat of vaporization for the solvent, whereas del H is the enthalpy of vaporization for the solvent, or M is the molar mass of the solvent. All these terms are for solvent component. Okay, so this is all about from elevation of boiling point. Two equation you should remember from this discussion, and in the next class we'll discuss about some problem based on this class. And in the problem part, we'll discuss about both topic, both colligative property, that is elevation of boiling point and depression of freezing point, because the problems of these two topics are very similar to each other. Okay, so this is it for today's class. I hope you guys have understood whatever the things I have discussed here. If you have any doubt, you can ask me on the comment section below. And if you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for instant notification. Thank you.